हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे लेट्स स्टार्ट द सब्जेक्ट डिजाइन ऑफ मशीन एलिमेंट्स एंड फ्रॉम दैट विल बी स्टडिंग पावर स्क्रू. सो बेसिकली व्हाट इज अ पावर स्क्रू? अ पावर स्क्रू इज अ मैकेनिकल डिवाइस और अ मैकेनिकल एलिमेंट कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ अ स्क्रू एंड नट जॉइंट फॉर कन्वर्टिंग रोटरी मोशन इंटू ट्रांसलेशनल मोशन. इट इज अ ट्रांसलेशनल स्क्रू विच इज यूज टू कन्वर्ट आवर रोटरी मोशन विच वी इम्पार्ट into translation motion. Let's see in the video, you'll get a clear idea about power screw. From the video, you must have got a clear idea about the power screw. Now, the power screw uses a helical rotary motion of screw thread to transmit power. The application: it is basically used to raise the load, to lower the load, to clamp a workpiece, or to apply load to a specimen. The first application of power screw. To raise a load. For example, take a simple automobile screw jack. When a tire gets punctured, you use a screw jack. Or a simple jack which consists of spring and a nut arrangement to raise the vehicle. Second, to obtain accurate motion. This accurate motion can be seen in a lathe machine. In a lathe machine where we use a lead screw. Third will be to hold or clamp a workpiece. To clamp a workpiece, where we can see this is the bench vise which we use in a workshop for clamping the jobs. And the fourth one will be to apply load on the specimen. It is used basically in the universal testing machine which we have studied in the subject strength of material to apply load on a specimen. So now the advantages of the power screw. Power screw are the first, very compact in design, very easy to design, and also they are used to convert rotary motion to translational motion. So the first advantage is simple to design, compact in the mechanical parts as well as the design. We have large mechanical advantage and we can make or design the power screw to be self-locking. Now, self-locking and overhauling concept will be explained further in this video, so stay tuned for that. Also, we have some limitations with the power screw. Let's look at that also. So, first advantage is simple in design, as it just consists of a screw and nut arrangement. Second will be compact. Okay, so the third will be large mechanical advantage, and fourth will be self-locking quality or property as suited. Also some limitations. So the first limitation with the power screw which we face is efficiency is low, that is only 40% of efficiency is achieved from a power screw. So low efficiency, as low as 40%, and also they are not very reliable and may be noisy in their application. So friends, as you have seen from the video, it is power transmission device. It consists of a nut and a screw. So terminology of a power screw, as you can see here, we have following terms: D, DM, DC, pitch and the lead. So the first terminology will be the D. D stands for nominal diameter, which is the largest diameter of a power screw. DM will be the mean diameter. We'll come back to this later. DC will be the core diameter, that is the minimum diameter of a power screw considered, and dm is equal to d plus dc divided by 2, that is the average of nominal and core diameter. Next we have pitch. The definition of pitch, as you may know, is the axial distance between two points on corresponding teeth. So we have pitch, and L is equal to lead of power screw, and the next definition is lead. So lead is the distance measured parallel to the axis of a screw within the nut will advance in one revolution. So for example, this distance will be the lead covered in one revolution of a power screw. And we have the alpha, which will be the inclination angle measured from the horizontal for every teeth. So now let's look at self-locking and overhauling properties of a power screw. First, let's see what is self-locking. Self-locking, we have two basic angles in a power screw, that is phi and alpha. When the phi is greater than alpha, then the torque required to lower the load is positive, which means we have to apply effort to lower the load and to raise the load. As this property is considered, the load will not turn the power screw down and it will not lower by itself. It will lock in the position as it was. Therefore, it is known as self-locking condition of a power screw. Now, if we look at overhauling, it is exactly opposite of self-locking, where phi will be less than alpha. When this property is taken into consideration, the load required to lower the load is negative. Therefore, the screw will turn on its own and it will raise by the effort we have applied. So this property is highly undesirable in power screw, and therefore this is known as overhauling, which is never considered while designing a power screw. So now let's take a numerical and see how a numerical is to be solved. Basically, while designing a power screw, we consider uniform wear theory and not the uniform pressure theory. You must have studied uniform wear theory and pressure theory in theory of machine. So let's see how it is applied, and let's take a numerical of the power screw. First question: the lead screw of a lathe has a single start thread. Single start. Nominal diameter 52 mm and pitch is 8 mm. Force exerted is 1.8 kN. Collar is provided to withstand the thrust load. The outer inner diameter of collar are 100 mm and 60 mm respectively. Coefficient of friction between thread and collar is 0.15 and 0.12. Screw speed 27 rpm. Calculate power and efficiency. As it is not mentioned uniform pressure theory or uniform wear theory, we'll be using uniform wear theory to find out the given problem. So let's take down the given properties or the given data we have from the numerical. First, we have trapezoidal thread. Start was given single, so n is equal to 1. Our 2 theta angle was given as we are using trapezoidal thread, it will be having 2 theta is equal to 30 degree. So theta is equal to 15 degree. Now, d is equal to 52 mm, the nominal diameter or the largest diameter if you remember. Pitch is 8 mm. And W will be the load, that is 1800 Newton. The outer diameter is 100 mm and the inner diameter is 60 mm. Coefficient of friction is 0.15 and for the collar it is 0.12. And also we have speed of 27 rpm. Now you have to find power, and second, efficiency. These are the two terms we have to find from the given data provided. As we are provided two diameters, we have to first find the nominal diameter, which is the average of outer diameter and core diameter. So, first step, mean diameter. dm, which will be d minus p by 2. So, these are the empirical relations we are provided. D will be 52 minus 8 divided by 2, which will be 48 mm. Okay, we have now the mean diameter. Second, we have to find out the helix angle, that is the inclination with the horizontal. Alpha will be tan inverse L upon pi diameter. So tan inverse. Lead, we know, will be number of start into the pitch upon pi into the nominal diameter. So putting all the values, we will get alpha as 3.0368 degrees. This will be in degrees and not in radians. So the next thing will be virtual coefficient of friction. Virtual coefficient of friction, that will be mu a. So the relation is mu upon cos theta, which will be 0.15 divided by cos 15. It will come approximately 0.1553. And phi, similarly, phi a is equal to tan inverse mu a, which is equal to 8.8275 degree. So now we have all the angles, and let's start calculation of the effort required to raise and lower the loads. So now let's calculate the effort required to raise the load against thread friction. Step 1. Effort to raise load. Let us denote it as PR. So PR is W tan phi A, that will be the virtual coefficient, plus alpha will be the helix angle. 1800 into tan 8.82 plus 3.0368. Try taking at least 3 numbers after the decimal, so we get an accurate answer. So PR will be 378.15 Newton, the effort required to raise a load. Now step 2, torque required to raise load. TTR, it is effort into distance, the diameter. It is equal to 378.15 into 48 divided by 2. TTR is equal to 9075. So we have the answer 9075.6 Newton mm. The third will be total torque required to overcome friction of the collar. Step 3, collar friction. Overcome, which will be TC. So TC is mu C, that will be the friction coefficient due to of the collar, into load, into mean radius RM. So we have R, we don't have the RM provided with us, so we can take it as DM divided by 2. Similarly, DM will be D0 plus DI. We have been given the collar diameters. Next, putting the values 0.12 into 1800 into 100 plus 60 divided by 4. We have to take the respective averages. So TC will be approx 8.460 Newton mm. So now we have the effort, the torque required to raise, and the torque required to overcome the thread friction or the collar friction. So calculating total torque to raise. It will be TTR plus TC. So TR is equal to 9.0756 plus 8.64, 17.7156 Newton meter. Remember, we have to take Newton meter while taking the final torque. The next step is calculating the power required. So the basic power formula will be used here to find out 2 pi n t upon 60. Now t will be the tr which we have found out, that is to raise the load. 2 into pi into 27 rpm into 17.7156 upon 60. Calculates. Let's do some math. Don't forget to use your calculator. You need to be used to your calculator, or else the calculation may go wrong in the examination. So it is 50.09 watt. So friends, we have almost finished our numerical, and the last step that is remaining is to find the efficiency. So the basic efficiency stands as output upon input. In this case, it will be work output in one revolution to work input in one revolution. That will be overall efficiency. Let's calculate the overall efficiency. The formula should be W into L, which will be the output, because we will get a lead, that is rotation of the power screw, and we will be lifting a load. Then the input will be the torque required to raise into 2 pi, which is 1800 into 8 upon the torque required is 17.7156 into 2 into pi. Okay, so this will be the formula. Here the pitch is in mm and the torque is in meter. Here you convert the pitch into mm, or convert torque into, either you convert pitch into meter or the torque into mm. We'll be considering converting torque into Newton mm, and therefore we'll be multiplying it with 1000. So calculating very carefully, 17.7156 into 2 pi into 1000, it is 0.129 into 100, which is 12.9%. So the initial assumption of having low efficiency as low as 40% stands true, and we get a efficiency of 12.9 mm. So this was a numerical on uniform wear theory. Let's consider a numerical on uniform pressure theory as well. So this is a May 2012 question, and it was written to solve it using uniform pressure theory. The numerical is the same, the format is the same. So let's start without further ado. The first step we do is calculating nominal diameter. For that, let's write down the given data. The given, a lead screw has an acme thread of 50 mm, outer diameter, pitch 8 mm, axial load is 3000 Newton, and collar thrust is 120 mm, outer diameter, and 60 mm, inner diameter. So the collar dimensions are 120 mm and 60 mm. Screw rotates at 40 rpm. Skin friction and collar friction are 0.15 and 0.12. Calculate power and efficiency based on uniform pressure theory. So the given data will come as D is equal to 50 mm, P is equal to 8 mm, D0 and DI 120 mm, DI will be 60 mm, mu will be 0.15, and mu C is equal to 0.12. We have W is equal to 3000 Newton. So this is the given data for the numerical to be solved using UPT. Let's start. And the first step is finding the mean diameter, which is D minus pitch divided by 2. So 50 minus 8 divided by 2. It should be 46 mm. The second step is finding alpha, that is the helix angle, tan inverse L upon pi dm. We don't have L, we have n into p upon pi dm. The start has not been given, so we assume it is a single start screw. Tan inverse 1 into 8 upon pi into 46. Now solving this, shift tan 1 into 8 upon pi into 46. It is 3.1686 degree. Try taking at least three numbers after the decimal. Next, we have to find mu a, that is mu upon cos theta, which will be 0.15 upon cos 14.5, because we have been given acme threads and not the trapezoidal threads in the last numerical. So 0.15 upon cos, it turns out to be 0.1549, and phi a is tan inverse mu a. So tan inverse 0.1549, 8.80. Similarly, the first step, effort to raise, which will be PR. So PR is equal to W tan phi A plus alpha. W is 3000 into tan into phi A, 8.805 plus alpha will be 3.1686. Calculating it, we will get it 636.23 Newton. Second step, torque to raise against friction, TTR will be PR into DM upon 2. So it will be 636.23 into 46 divided by 2, which will be 14633.29 Newton mm. It is the collar friction where uniform pressure theory is to be considered. Let's see how it applies. TC, that will be torque required to overcome friction at the collar. 2 by 3 mu W R0 cube minus Ri cube upon R0 square minus Ri square. So R0 and Ri will be the collar dimension that we have been provided in the numerical, which were 120 and 60. So putting all the values, 2 by 3 into 0.12, because we have to consider the collar friction, into 3000 into R0 and Ri, which will be averages. So 60 cube minus 30 cube upon 60 square minus 30 square. Calculating this term, we have 60 cube minus 30 cube upon 60 square minus 30 square, which is equal to 70 into 3000 into 0.12 into 2 divided by 3. So it is correct, it is 16800 Newton mm. We have all the torque required, so final total torque to raise will be TTR plus TC, which will be, it was 14.63 plus 16.8 Newton meter, which is equal to 31.433 Newton meter. Next step was calculating the power, which was 2 pi nt divided by 60. So 2 pi into n was given as 40, and t will be tr, 31.433 divided by 60. So power should be approximately 2 into pi into 40 into 31.433 divided by 60. 131.66 watt. This will be the power which we have to give. Next step and the final step was efficiency, which was W into L upon 2 pi into TR. So 3000 into N into P upon 2 pi into, and TR value was 31.833. So 3000 into 8 upon 2 pi into 31.833. It is approximately 11.9%, which is less than 50%, and therefore our numerical is correct. So this was all about the power screw using uniform pressure theory and uniform wear theory. In the next lecture, we'll be studying C-clamp as well as the screw jack. So do like, comment and subscribe, and as well as share. Comments are welcome. And signing off. Thank you.